Dear students, welcome back. Very good morning. As you know, the title we have written, chapter 1 continues, that's rational number. Today we welcome you in lecture number 2. Before we start, today lecture number 2, in lecture number 1, what we have done? In lecture number 1, you were explained the meaning of rational number. At the same time, we also have started section 1, that is addition, subtraction of rational number, if you can remember. We have started those examples and we have solved one example, if you can remember. Now, my dear student, in today's lecture, lecture number 2, we are again going to practice some more examples. Today, I am not going to take examples of division and multiplication. Today, whatever example we are going to solve here are all examples of addition and subtraction of rational number only. One example we have studied in our lecture number 1. Today in lecture number 2, we are going to solve some more example of the same category. And we will today move slowly so that any doubt or any speculation in your mind will get cleared. Okay, so today how we are going to move in this type of example? Once I write any example here and then I will dictate one step and I will write on the board, then we will take a little short time so that you can be watchful, understand that step, understand, then and then I will go for the next step. That is the way today we are going to solve all examples. So my dear student, be very very conscious, be very alert. And when you do any example, please note it down in your book. Calculate accordingly. Understand, then and then it will benefit you and you will be able to master this example. Okay, chalo. Suppose, let us write one example, okay? And let us try to solve. I am just continuing the series. One example we have already done of the same type in our lecture number 1. Let us take another one. Okay. Chalo, mari sathe. My dear students, start writing. Minus 4 upon 3. Okay. Plus minus 4 upon 5, okay, plus minus 2 upon 3, plus 7 upon 5, minus 2. This is the example written here. And let us try to solve it. Okay, Before I write, first step. Can anybody guess the first step? As in first example, what I suggested you, the successive sign needs to be solved first to avoid any error may arise. Okay, chalo. Let me write the first step only. Okay, let me write. You also write with me. Minus 4 upon 3. What could be the sign here? Plus, minus, minus 4 upon 5. Okay, dear student. Plus, minus, minus 2 upon 3, plus 7 upon 5, minus 2. There is nothing in denominator, so you can take 1. Chalo, first step, as I promised, in each and every step, a little time for you to understand. Whenever we get such type of example, the basic is to solve double sign. Double sign has to be solved first. Plus, minus, minus, plus, minus, minus. This is as it is. So we have done the first step. Second step is of equalizing denominator by taking LCM accordingly. As you all know, we have to take LCM of 3, 5 and 1, 15 only. Write LCM 15. Okay. Now, my dear student, if any doubt in your mind, please clear it with me. You have to bring 15 here. 3, how many ja 15? 5 ja. So let us multiply accordingly. 3, 5 ja. 5 also has to be multiplied with numerator. Okay. Minus. This is very important step. 5. How many ja 15? 3 ja. So 5, 3 ja, 4, 3 ja. Okay. 3, how many ja 15? 5 ja. So 5 here also. What you multiply in denominator to bring 15? You have to multiply with numerator, that you know the rule. Plus 7 upon 5. 5 3 ja, so 7 3 ja. Minus 2 upon 1. 1 15 ja, 2 15 ja. Okay, second step, before I move ahead, just have a look at this. Any doubt, you first clear in your mind, if you have any doubt. Okay, is it clear? Let us verify it. Equals to minus 20 upon 15. Okay, minus 4 3 ja 12 upon 15, minus 10 upon 15, plus 7 3 ja 21 upon 15, 15 2 ja 30 upon 15. The step is clear in your mind? Is it clear? Now it's a question of collecting numerator by putting common denominator. Let me write. Here, my dear student, concentrate. Minus 20, minus 12, minus 10, plus 21, minus 30, with common denominator, that is 15. Watch this step first. As I promised, I am taking only difficult example, not involving only two rational number. I am taking 5 to 6 rational number at a time, so that you master the concept and it becomes quite clear in your mind. Understand? That's why only. Now, first let me place the common denominator as it is. Now, my dear student, can you remind and understand what I suggested you? Whenever you come across so many numbers to be added or subtracted at a time, what I told you in previous example, first, my dear student, find all positive numbers and add them. How many positive number you see? Only one, that is 21. So first you write down 21. Now how many negative number? 1, 2, 3, 4, all are negative. What I taught you? Just add. Understand? 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 3, 7, okay, minus 72. Clear? No, 3 plus 1, 4, 5, 6, 7, okay, 72, quite clear. Only one positive number. If there may be more positive number, you will add them and write here. All negative number I have added and written here as minus 72. My dear student, 5 number reduced to just 2. Now you all know. Plus, minus, minus 72. Minus 21, okay. Obviously, sign of greater number, 2 minus 1, that is 1. 7 minus 2, that is 51 upon 15. Got the answer? If cancellation is possible, you need to do 3 5 ja, 3 17 ja. So our final answer will be minus 17 upon 5. Look at this sum, verify it. If any doubt, clear your mindset first. Then and then we will go for the next example. My dear student, it is involving already 5 rational number, addition and subtraction. So first, be watchful how to solve double sign, then how to take LCM, how to multiply. Please be watchful in this particular sum. Just 1 minute pause for your clear understanding of this sum. Just have a look at this, then we will go for some other example. But before that, your mindset has to be very, very clear regarding such type of examples. Just have a look. Try to understand how to take LCM, and here, my dear, no doubt we will practice some more example of this type, but here you should be very, very strict about how to solve this. It's not difficult. It's simply a question of how you concentrate. Understand? More you concentrate and more you solve such type of example, it will benefit you and it will enhance your thinking skill. Understand? Is it clear in your mind? Let us take another example of the same type, but little more difficult, so that your mindset becomes stronger and stronger in solving such type of examples. Okay? Let us take one more example. Okay? Example number 3. Just write down, suppose you think minus 7 upon 4, okay, plus 5 upon 3, plus minus 5 upon 6, plus 2, plus 1 upon 3, plus minus 1 upon 2. We have taken intentionally one big example so that examples of any type becomes clear in your mindset. Understand, maths is ultimately a subject of proper mindset and proper application of brain. Understand? Every student should remember one thing. No doubt you should spare time for physical exercise, you should go in ground for playing, understand? But balance yourself. Understand? Don't waste your time in just watching those video games and all those. Understand? Don't indulge yourself much on electronic media. Rather, you spare time for physical exercise, and then you should stay for relaxation, a little time for all those things which you are a hobbit person, understand? But you have to avoid it, okay? You need to concentrate more and more on mathematics. And my dear student, day by day the situation is getting worse and worse regarding Corona, okay? So at that time, you have to think differently. You need to start thinking in such a way that these online lectures are like offline, and you should think that you are sitting with your fellow student and attending the lecture. That is very, very important for you. That will, don't just attend the lecture leisurely. Attend the lecture with thorough consciousness, alertness, acuteness, to ascertain that by the end of the lecture, if you are able, at least I want that any example when given to you, at least by the end of the lecture, if you are able to instantly write those examples in some different page and solve correctly by yourself without looking in what you have written during the lecture, that is important. That is strengthening of your base. Okay? My dear student, the first step, first step will be opening double sign. That means solving the successive sign. Let me write the first step. Minus 7 upon 4 plus 5 upon 3 plus minus minus 5 upon 6 plus 2 upon, there is nothing, means we can place denominator 1 plus 1 upon 3 plus minus minus 1 upon 2. Okay, my dear student, first step has been done. Now it is a question of taking LCM for equalizing the denominator. You will take LCM of 4, 3, 6, 2 and 1. Obviously LCM will be 12, that too you know. How to take out LCM, I don't think it needed, because you already understood in previous standard how to take LCM. So LCM, my dear student, note it down, 12, okay? After noting down the LCM, let us try to equalize the denominator, okay? Let me write one by one. Minus 7 upon 4. What is the LCM we have taken? 12. For how many ja 12? 3 ja. So multiply 3 here also. Plus 5 3 ja. 3 how many ja 12? 4 ja, so 4 multiplied here, minus 5 upon 6, 6 how many ja, 12, 2 ja, so 2 multiplied here, plus 2 upon 1, 1 how many ja, 12, 12 ja, multiplied, plus 1 upon 3, 3 how many ja 12, 4 ja, 2 how this is I have written, 2 6 ja 12, 6 ja 12. Is this step clear in your mind, my dear student? Basic has to be made clear, basics, okay? Let us continue. Minus 21 upon 12 plus, concentrate student, 20 upon 12 minus 10 upon 12 plus 24 upon 12, okay, plus 4 upon 12 minus 6 upon 12. Difficult looking example, but if your basics are sound and clear, nobody can stop you from acquiring marks. Make your basics and make your fundamentals very clear. Now, common denominator, that is 12, okay. Write the rest of the number with the maintaining the sign, minus 21 plus 20 minus 10 plus 24 plus 4 minus 6. Chalo, my dear student, what I taught you? So many, see, if you have understood the basic I already taught you, then to any rational number may be given. You will never get confused at all. Understand? Otherwise, student indulge in this practice, minus, plus, minus, and minus, minus, plus, 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 minus, 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 plus. So that's a very, very laborious process and guarantees for sign mistake. Rather, I taught you already in our previous example also. Can you guess? What shall we do now? You will look for all numbers which are positive. How many? See, how many positive number you can visualize here? So plus 20, plus 24, plus 4, 3 positive number. Just add them. 20 plus 24, that is 44, plus 4, 48. Write it. You understood this? Now, how many negative number you are able to visualize here? The negative number, which are those? Minus 21, minus 10, minus 6. Just add them. Minus 20, just add them. 21 plus 10, 31. 31 plus 6, 37. Okay. Just put this sign. Okay. 37. Is it clear? Now, 6 number reduced to only 2 number. Now, to my dear student, nothing is there. 48 plus 48 minus 37, 8 minus 7, 1, 4 minus 3, 1, 11 upon 12. Such a simple, actually complicated looking sum was solved so simply. Understand? If you concentrate step to step, first 1-2 minutes pause for you, my dear student. Please watch each and every step and here don't make any mistake. That's very, very important for you. Verify it first before we move to next example. Please be watchful and when you do maths, please concentrate. And my personal guidance is, please sit alone in your room or in some place in your house where you should feel yourself alone and alone there, so that you can concentrate on video lecture. Not only you are able to concentrate, but at the same time you are able to catch things very, very clearly. And in maths, as I already told you, the basic concept understanding is a must, that you should know conceptual understanding, okay, of any sum. Before we move to next sum, first tell me, now is it clear in your mind? Okay, my dear student, is it clear? Verify the sum properly. And here should not make any mistake. That is very important, I told you. Understand? No mistake you should make here. Is it clear in your mind? Okay, my dear student, let us take another example. Okay, another one. No doubt, example is some a little type of word problem, not word problem of those section which we are going to discuss. It's a simple question, understand, of actually involving addition and subtraction only. That you should understand. It actually involves addition and subtraction only. Okay, my dear student, let us try to understand. I am writing the whole sum for you. Please write with me. This is the question, right? What should be, this is the question, what should be added to, what should be added to 1 upon 2 plus 2 upon 3 plus 4 upon 5 to get 3 upon 7. This is the question. First you need to understand the question. I am giving you little time first to understand the words given here. That's very important. First you need to understand the words. What actually they try to, no doubt it's one type of word problem you can consider, right? What should be added to 1 upon 2 plus 2 upon 3 plus 4 upon 5 to get 3 upon 7? Now, my dear student, little revision of that word problems in linear equation. What you have to add in this that you don't know, but when you add that number in this, what is the result? That is 3 upon 7. My dear student, you don't know what should be added to this. So what I don't know, may I suppose as x? You understood this? I don't know that what should I add to this to get the result 3 upon 7. So let me suppose, is that as? Let me write, let. Here you do not have to write the here, you have to write this, let x must be added. Only this much you have to write. Let x must be added to this to get the result 3 upon 7. Okay. Now, my dear student, try to express it symbolically. I will write 1 upon 2 plus 2 upon 3 plus 4 upon 5. I have to add that I don't know. So, I write plus x. And what is the result we are getting? 3 upon 7. Is this clear in your mind, my dear student? What was the question? What should be added to? 1 upon 2 plus 2 upon 3 plus 4 upon 5. We don't know, so we added x. And by adding x to this, what is the result we are getting? 3 upon 7. Now, it's a question of transferring all terms there with sign change. Understand? Therefore, x equal to. First, I am writing this 3 upon 7. Now you are transferring all this term on that side, so sign change. Minus 1 upon 2, minus 2 upon 3, minus 4 upon 5. Up till this, is this example clear in your mind, my dear student? Is it clear? Now it's a question of taking LCM, okay? What could be the LCM? 7, 2, 3, 5. You have to take LCM. All are prime numbers. See, 7, 2, 3, 5. So just multiplication. Understand? 7, 5, 35. 35, 2, 70. 73, 210. So LCM is 210. Let us work accordingly. 7, how many 210? 30 So here also 30. 2, how many 210? 105 So here also 105. 3, how many 210? 70 Here also 70. 4 upon 5, how many 210? See, 5, 4 21, 5, 2 means 42 Okay, let us solve them. Therefore, x is equal to 33, this one, 90 upon 210. 105 upon 210 minus 140 upon 210 minus 42 8, 44 16 upon 210. Okay, so we got the common denominator already. Therefore, x equal to, first you write the common denominator 210, then this 90 minus 105 minus 140 minus 168. I continue this sum here, my dear student, just be watchful, is equal to, first let me write the common denominator, that is 210, and now, again the check of the basic, how many number there? 4. How many positive? Only 1. Let us write that first. 3 negative number, add them. See, 8 plus 5, 13, that is 3. 1 carry, 6 plus 1, 7, 7 plus 4, 11, understand, 1, 1 carry, 1 plus 1, 2 plus 3 plus 4, okay, minus, so you got, it is reduced to this, plus, minus, minus, subtract 90 from 413, okay, first 90 from 400, so it will be 300 and 90 from 400, okay, so 310, right, plus 13, 323, so minus 323, understood, this is the answer, cancellation is not possible, so this is your final answer, so write your final answer yourself, what you will write? Minus 323 upon, write it, note down in your book. Write your final answer. So, minus 323 upon 210 should be added to this, alakhon, to get 3 upon 7, this way. Be watchful and verify this sum before we still solve one more example of the same type. I am just leaving screen for your understanding only. Verify each and every step and try to understand the sum. What is given in the sum that you need to understand quite consciously. Is it clear, my dear student? Let us take another example of the same type, okay? Let us take another example. Suppose the question is like this. Let me write question for you. Let us write. Question is, what should be, write with me the question, what should be subtracted, okay, what should be subtracted from, write the question with me, what should be subtracted from minus 3 upon 4 to get, here only I will write, to get 5 upon 6, that's the question. Before we solve, first you understand the question. The basic needs to be understood. What should be subtracted from this means you have to subtract one number which you don't know, that is x, from this to get 5 upon 6. Okay, let us write the statement. Let x must be subtracted. Okay, first you should write. If added, so you have to write, well, let x must be added. Subtracted, let x must be subtracted from what? Minus 3 upon 4. Write this way. minus 3 upon 4, x is to be subtracted, so minus x, and what you are getting, my dear student, 5 upon 6. Chalo, transfer this. So here what is left on left hand side? Minus x equal to 5 upon 6, sign change, plus 3 upon 4. Now the question of equalizing denominator 6 and 4, what could be the LCM? Tell me. 12. Let us accordingly try to equalize denominator 6 to the 12, 2 to be multiplied here, 3 upon 4, 4 3 the 12 to be multiplied here. So this would be 10 upon 12 plus 9 upon 12. Now try to understand common denominator. Okay, 10 plus 9. So minus x equal to 19 upon 12. Cancellation is not possible. Just change the sign. Minus 19 upon 12. So what could be your final answer? What you will write? X equal to minus 19 upon 12. So final answer, I'm just dictating you. What will you write in your final answer? Just write down minus 19 upon 12 should be subtracted from minus 3 upon 4 to get 5 upon 6. You understood, my dear student? So in today's lecture, we have solved all examples involving addition and subtraction of rational number. We will solve some more examples of addition and subtraction involving multiplication and division in our next lecture. Okay, my dear student, practice all some thoroughly at home. And be very punctual in maths. Practice it. Again, practice, practice and practice. That will make you perfect in solving your basics in mathematics. Okay, my dear student. Thank you very much from Bharat sir.